Here in today's Medical Watch, a virus that can cause polio-like illness in children is spiking in the U.S. Researchers say they are seeing more evidence of it in wastewater collected around the country. It's called Enterovirus D68, and Dr. Larry Kosiolik is an infectious disease specialist at Lurie Children's Hospital here in Chicago and is joining me now to talk a little bit more about this. Describe this virus for me, and why should it be so concerning for both doctors and parents at home?
Yes, and so enterovirus is a type of virus that has 100 different types. So it's a very large and diverse group of viruses. And every year, somewhere between 10 million and 15 million enterovirus infections occur in the United States. So it's a very, very common cause of things like vomiting and diarrhea, or a common cold, and can occasionally cause more severe symptoms. Now, there's also a condition that's called acute flaccid myelitis. Doctors also call it AFM. Now, that is a syndrome that can present like polio with some weakness or even paralysis related to the complications from this virus. But that complication, AFM, is exceedingly unusual. The vast majority of cases of this enterovirus D68 will not be associated with this complication. And so while these viruses are increasing, and they increase every year around this time, late summer or early fall, the likelihood for getting this more severe complication is very, very low.
Okay. In the meantime, I mentioned in the story that they've been collecting our wastewater, and that's how they know that right now the levels of this virus are at what they call medium levels. So describe to me what that means in terms of the amount of people who may be exposed or may have this already or may have had it this fall.
Yes. And so every year around this time, we see an increase in enteroviruses, and particularly this specific enterovirus D68. Last year around this time, we saw a ton of respiratory infections caused by that, but really did not see a spike in this AFM. So wastewater can measure certain pathogens that humans release through their stool and are collected at wastewater plants. And so these epidemiologists will measure the amount of these pathogens in that wastewater and classify it as either low, medium, or high. The doctors that measure that have their own metrics for doing it, but medium means that it's increasing in the population relative to the baseline. And so it does mean that it's circulating. That is not of any particular surprise to pediatricians right now, but it does raise the concern that because we're seeing it, we just need to have more vigilance for this complication of AFM than we would during periods when we're not seeing this virus.
Okay, be more vigilant. That is the advice that you give to parents. So what else should they know about it or look for in their children if perhaps they're worried that this could be an issue for them?
The most worrisome symptoms would be related to this paralysis. So if parents are seeing their children have weakness, particularly of one limb, like one arm or one leg, or perhaps their face, those are symptoms that are very concerning and need to be brought to the attention of their pediatrician or the emergency department right away.
All right, Dr. Larry Kosiolik, infectious disease specialist over at Lurie Children's Hospital. We appreciate your time.
Thanks so much.